We heard them, yeah.
Thanks very much. So, we're going to play a couple of tunes now. Excuse me, please. The first one was a strathspey or Scottish recorded by Michael Coleman back in the 20s called Stirling Castle. Scottish tune in origin, I'd say, but a lot of tunes travel across from Scotland to Donegal and back, so we can't claim ownership, but we're related anyway, so there you go. And the second and third tunes are two flings, which I learned from the aforementioned Seamus Quinn, the Derry Gonnelly, County Fermanagh man, fiddle and piano player. He would be the closest living musician to the music of the 1920s. That's authentic. I mean, he's alive now playing music today, but it's where he was plucked out of the 20s. He just has that thing. There's no one else like him. Unbelievable. And he was the source of the second and third tunes, which I don't have a name for, sadly, yet. But I'll work on it for the next tour.
The last one's called the Money Musk.
Is it?
The Money Musk, yeah. Money Musk.
Money Musk.
Yeah.
Maybe.
A box player called PJ Conlon from a village called Irishtown, County Mayo, recorded a lot.
Irishtown?
Irishtown. And he recorded a lot of 78s back today as well. But there was a compilation recording done lately of his music. And shortly before I came out, I got a copy of it. And
so three CDs?
It's four.
Jesus.
Yeah. Let's get that. A fantastic melodeon player.
In New York?
He'd have been in New York, yeah. He'd been around the same time as Coleman and Morrison and Kimmel and all these boys.
He would have recorded with Morrison.
Famous track, Moving Ball. But anyway, it's a great recording and it's a very strange name. The Money Musk. I have been wrong once before, you know. That wasn't my fault either, so.
That was a mistake.
Huh?
That was a mistake.
Of course they lied.